Now the sudden atmosphere where Supreme Court is coming down hard on criticism, or is there a general fear that the stature of the court is being lowered?
Look, the recent judgment in the case of Prashant Bhushan, where he criticized the Chief Justice sitting on a motorcycle while other things were pending, etc. And he was convicted for sentence of one day, etc. I personally don't agree with that view of the court. And in the current scenario, where the current Attorney General has given consent to initiate criminal contempt proceedings against a comic actor or a young girl for whom I'm appearing, a journalist who has lampooned or, created caricatures. I have said earlier also that if I was the Attorney General, I would not have given this consent. These are two small and insignificant instances in the life of a court or life of a judiciary to take any notice. In fact, by taking notice, you are unnecessarily giving, a significant exposure to these people, which actually they don't deserve. So there are many things which are best left, untouched or unsaid, and the court forges ahead. I mean, every day, don't you see that there is lampooning by the media of all kinds of politicians, from the Prime Minister downwards, opposition party downwards? But they don't take all these things, in a very heavy or a heavy-handed fashion. These things happen in public life. Courts are also in public gaze. Politicians are in public gaze. There is freedom of expression. Now, I would lean in favor of freedom, even if it is kind of borderline. I mean, it's not such a great thing that you lampoon and all that. And mind you, let me tell you and your viewers, there is a famous spy catcher case in England. Now, that judgment, the press was furious with that judgment. There were three judges involved in that case. So, on the front page of a leading newspaper called The Guardian, they printed the photograph of three judges upside down, right? And the caption of the news article was, "You old fools." Now, if you say stuff like that in the current scenario, it would certainly amount to contempt. But in England, when this issue was raised, the judges said that the shoulders of the court are broad enough to take criticism. And the leading judge said, "Old I am, fool or not is for the public to decide. So what's the big deal about it?" Right? So I've said earlier that these insignificant things, they come, they go by in a democracy. To take notice of these insignificant things, you're losing sight of the real road, or the real reason, or the real path that you have to go. And the foundations of the court or the judiciary is broad enough or powerful enough to take these kind of things in a stride and go on. I mean, it doesn't augur well for a court to take contempt action against these kind of things. Contempt action is taken against a motivated kind of an attack. Let me give you an example. Contempt action was taken by the Supreme Court against a practicing lawyer some time ago because some scurrilous attacks were being made against a judge. There was constant interference in the manner of, court proceedings. Suppose I constantly go on, interfere as a lawyer or as a litigant in court proceedings. I don't allow the court to function. keep shouting or disrupting the court proceedings, etc., etc. Those are situations where this action has to be taken because the court gets paralyzed in its working. And then a contempt action was taken. Let me give you another example. Some years ago, a litigant threw a chappal at a judge. Some poor litigant, on account of frustration. So many in the Supreme Court, so many dates had come, so many dates will go, so many years had gone. Promptly, one judge at whom the chappal was thrown decided to take contempt action there and then and gave punishment for 3 months or something. The other judge did not agree with the manner of procedure adopted by the senior judge in taking contempt action. Then you can't immediately, you see contempt, put somebody in jail and all that. And obviously, it's a disgrace to throw a chappal. But at the end of the day, if you look back at the history of that case or that person may have gone through, that for 20, 30 years, you are without a job, you have no money to maintain yourself. Things like that, if that is so, then you kind of best, you overlook these things. I mean, that's the way I would look at things. And if I was the Attorney General, I would never have given consent in the case of this comic actor and that young girl who had made a caricature. Maybe in bad taste,